Hello friends, welcome to our channel TechnoFeed. Today I will introduce you the new honey code made for application development. AWS announced the beta launch of Amazon Honeycode, a new fully managed no-code development tool that aims to make it easy for anybody in a company to build their own applications. Amazon Honeycode includes templates for some common applications that you and other members of your team can use right away. You can customize these apps at any time and the changes will be deployed immediately. You can also start with an empty table or by importing some existing data in CSV form. The applications that you build with Honeycode can make use of a rich palette of user interface objects including lists, buttons, and input fields. You can also take advantage of a repertoire of built-in, trigger-driven actions that can generate email notifications and modify tables. Honeycode also includes a lengthy list of built-in functions. The list includes many functions that will be familiar to users of existing spreadsheets, along with others that are new to Honeycode. For example, FindRow is a more powerful version of the popular VLOOKUP function. Getting started with Honeycode, it is easy to get started. I visit the Honeycode builder and create my account. After logging in, you can see my drive with my workbooks and apps, along with multiple search, filter, or view options. You can open and explore my existing items, or you can click Create Workbook to make something new. I do that, and then select the simple to-do template. After you create the new workbook, the tasks table is displayed, and you can see the sample data. Although this looks like a traditional spreadsheet, there's a lot going on beneath the surface. Let's go through column by column. A. Task plain text. B. Assignee text formatted as a contact. C. First name text computed by a formula. In the formula, assignee refers to column B, and first name refers to the first name of the contact. D. Due, a date, with multiple formatting options. E. Done, a pick list that pulls values from another table, and that is formatted as a Honeycode row link. Together, this restricts the values in this column to those found in the other table. Done, in this case, with the values yes and no, and also makes the values from that table visible within the context of this one. F. Remind on, another pick list, this one taking values from the remind options table. G. Notification, another date, this particular table uses just a few of the features and options that are available to you. You can use the icons on the left to explore my workbook. You can see the tables. You can also see the apps. A single Honeycode workbook can contain multiple apps that make use of the same tables. I'll return to the apps and the app builder in a minute, but first I'll take a look at the automations. Again, all of the tables and apps in the workbook can use any of the automations in the workbook. The Honeycode app builder. Let's take a closer look at the app builder. As was the case with the tables, I will show you some highlights and let you explore the rest yourself. Here's what I see when I open my simple to-do app in the builder. This app contains four screens: My Tasks, All Tasks, Edit, and Add Task. All screens have both web and mobile layouts. Newly created screens, and also those in this app, have the layouts linked so that changes to one are reflected in the other. I can unlink the layouts if I want to exercise more control over the controls, the presentation, or to otherwise differentiate the two. Objects within a screen can reference data in tables. For example, the list object on the My Tasks screen filters rows of the tasks table, selecting the undone tasks and ordering them by the due date. Here's the source expression. The pratishat in the filter condition is replaced by the second parameter, yes. When the filter is evaluated, the substitution system makes it easy for you to create interesting or powerful filters using the filter function. When the app runs, the objects within the list are replicated, one per task. The Add Task screen prompts for the values that specify the new task dot, and the Add button uses an automation that writes the values to the tasks table. Automations can be triggered in four different ways. Here's the automation that generates reminders for tasks that have not been marked as done. The automation runs once for each row in the tasks table. The notification runs only if the task has not been marked as done, and could also use the filter function. While I don't have the space to show you how to build an app from scratch, here's a quick overview. Click Create Workbook and import CSV file or start from scratch. Click the Tables icon and create reference and data tables. Click the Apps icon and build the app. You can select a wizard that uses your tables as a starting point, or you can start from an empty canvas. Click the Automations icon and add time-driven or data-driven automations. Share the app, as detailed in the next section. After my app is ready to go, I can share it with other members of my team. Each Honeycode user can be a member of one or more teams. To share my app, I click Share App. Then I search for the desired team members and share the app. they will receive an email that contains a link and can start using the app immediately. Users with mobile devices can install the Honeycode Player, iOS, Android, and make use of any apps that have been shared with them. Here's the simple to-do app. So thanks for watching this video. I hope you loved it, and please show love and subscribe our channel so that we are encouraged and we make more videos for you all.